Of my career tips for software testers. Today we're going to be talking about developing technical skills. Here's the overview of the structure we're going to do today. We're going to go through my personal tips. We'll go through some other online resources for developing your technical skills, and I'll have some final notes to say. This is going to be a four-part series, mini-series within a series, but hold your horses and we'll get into it. So to start off with, my first tip for improving your technical skills is to get comfortable with the command line. You will impress all of your colleagues if you do everything from the command line. You'll seem like a technical pro. It doesn't matter if you're just checking your emails. So if you want to get comfortable with the command line, I recommend a more Linux-based, because I don't like Windows command line too much, simply because like backslashes are in the wrong direction and it's just not what I'm used to. But you could learn some bash scripting too if you like. So for example, in Linux, there's a Vim editor, and there is an online game you can play to learn Vim. So if I just press any keys, whoop, we got some sound. And my screen doesn't work all that well, but that's fine. So this game teaches you different, so you can move your cursor around and whatnot. Vim Adventures is a fun little game for learning how to use the Linux-based text editor Vim. There's a couple of other different text editors, but I like Vim. It's what I'm used to. If you want to learn more other Linux command lines, there's Terminus, which is also another online game developed by MIT. And you can do things like ls to look around. You can find out what directory you're in if you're in PWD. You can change your directory as well. So we've got a location. Let's go into MIT. I have moved to MIT. If I ls around there, I can clear and start again. I'm in and whatnot. So getting familiar with the command line will make you look very technical. If you want another way to impress people with technical skills, there is Hacker Typer as well. This is like, you can just type any random stuff and you look like an ultimate hacker. Look at that. Anyway, that's just a random side note. There are some resources for learning Git as well. You can do all of Git from the command line too. I prefer to do Git from the command line, but there are tons of UI tools. I think if you have a good understanding of how to use Git from the command line, it makes the visual tools a lot easier to use. I'd recommend starting with Git from the command line and understanding some of those commands as well. There's a bunch of cheat sheets and handbooks and getting started material as well. If you do want to develop more technical skills, I would recommend getting a group of people together. I've never finished an online course or learnt anything on my own. I really enjoy learning with other people. When I wanted to go through some of the test automation uni days, I actually invited some people over. I'd prepare lunch and a workshop, and we just do the online lectures together. So for example, we'd watch through Angie Jones's setting up a foundation for successful test automation. I set up my lounge room with a projector and my gear, and had a bunch of people over. And I did some sketch notes while we did chapter one as well. I really enjoy sketch noting because it helps keep me on track with the learning I'm doing. If I'm watching an online video or a conference lecture, and if I'm not drawing notes, I'll get distracted by the infinite internet distraction pocket in my pocket. So I recommend taking some sketch notes while you're learning as well, because it helps for me. And we also broke for lunch as well. And I prepared a falafel help yourself Turkish lunch. And that was really good. I really enjoyed getting people together to practice learning. So if you are hoping to improve your technical skills, I would recommend doing it with people and start with the command line. Thank you.